everybody. This is a how-to video that I'm putting together as different teaching materials, but if you use Zoom, this will also be useful for you. I am CR Grimmer. This is my channel, The Poetry Vlog, and this sequence is part of a larger playlist. You can link in the eye icon on your YouTube screen above, and there you'll find the videos that pair with this. So in this video, we will tackle Zoom recordings in the cloud without thinking about Canvas integration. This makes it useful to folks who are instructor students or not even remotely affiliated with an institution, and will also give you a little bit more insight into which one you might prefer. While this video is designed to go for folks who need to teach and record their lectures and upload them for accessibility on Canvas, it's also here for you if you use Zoom regularly and you're having a hard time sending different video files. The video I created that pairs with this is what to do if you're saving your files to your computer instead of to the cloud. So this video builds on that. It suggests that if you're having that much trouble uploading different video files or figuring them out locally on your computer, and if that video didn't fix most of the different problems you're running into, this video will help you just link to it from the cloud and get out of that altogether. All right, I'm going to switch over to screen sharing mode now, and you're going to see different ways to use the Zoom cloud controls for your videos, your audio, transcripts, and so on. Enjoy. Where I have already signed in to Zoom. So when I signed in, this was my landing page. Anytime I click on the Zoom in the corner, I re-sign in and I land here. This includes non-UW ones. If we go down to recordings, you can see some of the ones I've been having already, and you can see local recordings as well. I want to focus on if you select cloud recordings, because when you start to record an episode, you'll get a little box that pops up, a little dialog box that says cloud or local. You want to choose cloud for the option I'm about to share with you. You'll notice again how long it can take to process a longer video, so keep that in mind. I'll publish it over and over in this how-to. I'm going to select this one. You'll notice when I clicked on it, so I'll do that again in case you didn't notice, click on it, that there's a variety of file types that you can check out. One is the chat file. You can download it, or you can send a shareable link to it, or you can just get rid of it. This is the file where any chatting that happened online will actually be saved as a text transcript. So that chat function where maybe, according to my other video suggestions, for instance, you have students taking notes or you put different resources for students to follow, this is the file of all of that conversation. You'll also notice that there's a speaker view version of the video, and then there's a gallery view version of the video. This has saved both for you. This is audio only, so just an audio transcript of the actual episode or information, and then there's an audio transcript, meaning a typed out version of what was said based on Zoom's own interface. It's likely that you'll have to go in and actually make micro edits to it. So I'll pull one of those up in a moment. You can rename what that meeting was here. I'll call it test for now. And then what I really love is, in addition to the recording analytics, which basically just tells you like what you've done with it, who's used it, yada, yada. You can go back and you can actually either download the files and re-upload them or just copy a shareable link. The reason this is fantastic is because if you don't have the time to figure out how to make your file size smaller and reshare in your portals or upload it, for a smaller setting where you just need people to go in and look at the actual recordings, you can just copy paste this link. The same function applies here, but you have a lot more options. Let me back that up. So here I did copy shareable link. Here there's just the share button, and you can decide if only authenticated signed in users in your account can view it, or if it's available publicly. You can decide if the viewer will be allowed to download it or not, which is very important for privacy. You can decide if you need people to pay for registration to view it. You can password protect the file. When you send the shareable link, it will give all of that information. I highly recommend making sure you've decided in advance how you feel about if viewers can download it or if you want them to only be able to view it in the context of where you sent them the link. Meaning, say you post this shareable link in a Canvas announcement so that the class can go back over the lecture notes. If you don't want them to download that video or you're worried about its distribution, well, it's not a perfect fail-safe. This is one small step you can take to protect that information. So that goes over the basics of what you'll find here. Which one you would prefer will depend on a variety of pros and cons. I am going to edit in the exact same pros and cons list in each video, so if you see that duplicated, know you're watching the right video. I just want to make sure that you know which one you prefer no matter which video you watch. So pros, if you're an instructor or student and Zoom is integrated into the Canvas portal, you can just toggle on publish, which will be shown in the how-to video, and anyone in that class can now view the video, the transcript, and the audio recording by streaming it and having to sign into the Zoom Canvas portal. The con is you have very little control over the types of files that are recorded and that you share, the privacy settings for downloading, and easily naming and manipulating the files. So if you're saving your Zoom video files to the cloud and you're not going to use the Canvas integration, it might be because you either don't have it or you prefer to have a little bit more control over what you're sharing. In that case, the pros would be you'll have multiple file types, gallery view, speaker view, audio, transcript, chat, all of them will be right there. You'll have the capacity to name them. There's multiple ways to share the individual files, so just the audio, just the chat, just the video, whatever you prefer. You can set up password protection on it, and you can set it up so that anybody who has the share link is unable to download the file. Again, what you prefer really depends on what you're comfortable with. I recommend if you're feeling anxious about using Zoom in the classroom and you have Canvas and you want the least work possible, just click publish and save them to the cloud and use Canvas integration. If you don't have Canvas or if you want to have that extra layer of control, then I recommend learning how to access them in the cloud and share from there.